Hi everyone and welcome back. And in this video we are going to talk about GraphQL client. Okay, and this is just a GitHub link. This is the GitHub repository and this is what we are covering, Yoga GraphQL. And here I will add the new folder GraphQL client that will talk about how to do the integration with the React. That's it. Okay, here we are with the Apollo client. Okay, so we have written a GraphQL client using Yoga GraphQL. I mean, your server side implementation can be anything. Your client side library, either you use the URQL or Apollo client, it can be anything because all these libraries are adopting the common standards. We have a GraphQL server written in the Yoga GraphQL. Now at the client side, I can simply use Apollo GraphQL client. Okay, and it is the same client. I mean, it just if we talk about the basic REST APIs, then either you make a call with the request module or with the Axios module or with a simple HTTP client, right? In the same language, in the GraphQL, there are multiple client-based libraries. The only difference here is in the HTTP definitions, we are doing get, put, post, patch, delete. Here we are going to call query mutation subscription on the HTTP post. And these are helper libraries which are going to help us to integrate with the GraphQL query and mutation at the client side. Our server is ready. Server is serving the queries and mutation. Now at the client side, either we use a GraphQL, React, Vue.js. There are common standard libraries are available like Apollo GraphQL client. Okay, using this, it's like we are integrating with the backend. Same we were doing with Axios in the legacy in the REST API world. Now it's a GraphQL API world. So here we are using Apollo GraphQL client. Okay. The documentation is pretty much simple, and GraphQL client supports all these different frameworks, Angular, Vue, Ember, Backbone, whatever you think of. And we'll just go to the basic documentation and then we'll start writing it. Okay. And as you know, we are using hooks in React, like use effect, use state, use reducer and all. Similarly, the Apollo GraphQL client also provides these simple hooks to make a query, make a mutation, and all these things. You might already heard of these Redux hooks. Like now, there are simple hooks, use selector, use dispatch, right? So earlier, we were writing map state to props, map dispatch to props, and a lot of boilerplate code we used to write. Now, with the introduction of hooks, we just need to use dispatch if we need to trigger action to the Redux. We are just using use selector if we wanted to get the state from the Redux. Similarly, here we are using use query, use mutation. Okay, whatever we were doing earlier without hooks, we were writing a lot of code to make a query and mutation. Now everything is just a simple hook. Okay, for the mutations, there is a use mutation. Okay, before even talking about all these things, what setup we need? Because it's like we need to talk to the GraphQL server. We also need to listen to the subscription. So it's like a WebSocket communication we need to establish. And for GraphQL query and mutation, we need to establish a HTTP based communication. Okay, so if we go ahead and see this, how to do the simple setup, we are going to install the basic Apollo client GraphQL library. And this is pretty much, okay, what we are doing here is we are doing Apollo client. So we get the client instance. Okay, now this client instance we can pass in our component wrapper. Okay, so I think here we can say yes, Apollo provider. Like you might have used provider in the Redux, that once if you are using the Redux with your React application, then you are adding the provider and you are passing the store. Similarly, now here we are using Apollo client. So we have to say, okay, all the components can access the Apollo utilities. So we are putting the Apollo provider and passing the client, and client is nothing but the Apollo client, and you are passing the URI of that Apollo and the cache. This you can create using HTTP link. So before that, you will create a HTTP link and then you will pass it. So we will see that in the code. And then once this is done, this is the step one, how you integrate the client. And then in your any of your component, you can trigger these kind of queries. These queries will be inside a GQL, okay, like this is the query name, and inside this query, this is the actual query you are triggering for the rates passing the currency. And this query now you can directly execute using use query, and it will maintain all different state. Loading means the query is being made. This is the loading state. Error means something, some error has occurred, the validation error, or the server is not running, server, something happened. And data means you have received the data from the GraphQL query. Accordingly, with those three different states, you can show loading, error, and now I have a data, so I can render it. Okay, this is a plain and very simple, like we were doing with it with the Axios in the HTTP world. Here we are just doing it with the GraphQL client in the GraphQL world. Here this can be a query, this can be a mutation also, but this is a kind of simple setup, right? Now these are the two hooks, use query and use mutation. Queries are for triggering the queries. Use mutation is to trigger the mutation. Okay, now what we will do is, let's see this in the action. Let's set up this. Okay, here is our code. We don't have anything. We are going to start from scratch. What all different libraries we need, we can see that in the package.json. I have already added them. Apollo React, React hooks, because we wanted to use query and use mutation. These are the code dependency. And to integrate the graph, to do the integration with the GraphQL, you need GraphQL, you need Apollo client web service. This is for WebSocket. This is Apollo link WebSocket. And then this is React Apollo library, and then GraphQL library, and the React Apollo link WebSocket. These are the main dependencies you need to add. And now, let's say you have created some index.js component. Let's say you have in the SRC, we will be adding few components to consume our post mutations and the user queries and all. So how we should start? Like, this is our root component. Here we will do import React from React. Okay, and we'll import React DOM and all these other libraries. And this pop-up is creating trouble. React DOM from disable this for now. And here we have another library. Okay, here we get the React DOM.